Hey everyone, welcome to our channel JavaBeam, and this is Satya. In this video I am going to explain you about the amazing transformation of switch cases from switch statement to switch expression. We all know like a switch is a statement in Java as of now, but in Java 14 it is a switch expression. We will see how it is being transformed over the period. We will see with examples, real-time example, what were the problem statement and how it has been resolved over the period in each some of the releases the enhancements happened to switch. So switch statements are imported from C language, so it is packaged, and whatever the features available in C related to switch are imported to Java. In Java initial versions, the switch is giving very limited features are limited benefits to developers, and it has been transformed and it has been enhanced so many things. We'll see. So before Java 5, it is expecting only numbers and characters, so it is not accepting any strings. Numbers in the sense it's only integers. We know like we'll write as each switch statement and we'll keep the cases. Each case after performing business logic will keep a break. Let me go to Eclipse. We'll see with examples. The problem statement is, I have date. Each day I'm going to perform some business logic. On Monday I will do some logic, and Tuesday I want to perform something. I have strings. Switch is not allowing strings here. What I have to do to resolve this issue? What I was doing is, I am mapping the strings like each day to one number using hash map. Instead of passing string, I am passing the number here. That is the indirect thing I am doing here, because it doesn't allow strings in Java 4, JDK 4. And each switch inside that will write multiple cases, and each case need to be do break. If we forget to keep break, what will happen is it will continue execute the next case. This is one unexpected behavior we are going to see if you forget to keep the break. This is called false true. That is one issue. Other issue is switch doesn't return any values. In case one, I want to return some value, but it's not possible. To return value, what I am doing indirectly, I am taking one variable and assigning value, and finally returning that variable. This is how we are doing. JDK 5 release, enums are released, or enums are introduced in JDK 5. From that onwards, switch cases are allowing enums. We'll see one example quickly. Yeah, this is the JDK 5. This is how we write enums in Java. Enums are nothing but constants. Instead of representing strings, we can use a string constant. We can go with the enums. These are the types of enums. These are safely we can use, which are constants. So switch cases we can follow. We can pass the enums. Instead of strings or instead of numbers, I can use enums here. This is the one change happened in JDK 5 for switch statement. Let's go to the next release. In JDK 7, switch statements are allowing strings. So this is a good improvement in switch cases. JDK 7 onwards, I able to pass directly strings. In Java 4 here, I couldn't able to pass the string, and only it is allowing number or character. That's the reason instead of string, I am converting a string to number, mapping some string to number, and I'm passing that number to switch. This one, whatever the transformation from string to number, I can avoid all this, and simply I can use strings directly. See, I able to pass the string to switch, and switch is allowing, and based on that string here, what happened is the readability is improved, and some redundant code I able to remove that one. Let's go to next release. Yeah, in Java 12, that so many things are enhancements happened to switch. Now switch is became switch case, or switch statement is became a switch expression. the behavior has been extended. From Java 12 onwards, we can use either switch statement or switch expression. If you think about the expression, it resembles something like lambda expressions, and syntax also similar to like this. The notation which we use for lambda expressions, same expression, same thing we use in switch expressions. We will see with example how the switch expressions are much better or giving solutions to most of the problems. So we already discussed the problem statement is, it is coming to the switch statement, each case is not returning any value. We can't return any value in previous releases, previous versions, and we need to keep the break. If you forget to keep the break, it is a false through. So it's going to execute the next cases until it encounters the break keyword. That is a one issue. See, let me run this one. Now I got C for Tuesday here. For Tuesday, what is the output I am expecting is B. B is the output I am expecting, but it got C because we forget to keep the break. That's the reason continue to execute next case as well, and it's printed C. So to avoid this, we need to remember to keep the break. That is one issue, and other issue is it is not returning any value. And one more thing here, I cannot keep multiple labels. Let's say case Friday and Saturday and Sunday, I want to execute same business logic, but I cannot give the same logic on comma separated. Like I cannot give like Friday, Saturday, something like I cannot give. What I have do is only without breaks I need to keep that, so that for Friday this logic execute, and even for Saturday same logic will execute, Sunday same logic will execute. This is how we were writing. Let me copy this code from JDK 7 and in Java 12 how we can improvement or how we can achieve the switch expressions to resolve all of the issues. Quickly transform this. So as we discussed, switch can return a value. Let me give the return value captured. So I'm capturing this value. This is one thing. Other thing, each case can return a value. So to return and to write the switch expression, we have to do something like this. This is the expression we have to give. This is a notation we need to keep, and to return a value for each case, we have to do something like this. Whatever the value you want to return, simply you can return without any return statement or without anything. You just need to keep like this. You don't need to take any variable, and you don't need to keep the break. Break is not required in expressions. Same way for Tuesday also, I am writing B, so that's fine. So I can remove this one. Coming to Wednesday, C is the expected output. Let me remove this. And coming to Thursday, it is a D, so simply we can write like this. And here, instead of three cases, what I can do, I can write a single case where I can keep the all the labels, comma separated labels we can keep in expressions. So this is how we can write, and the expected output is in expression something like this. Remove this. Yeah, that's all. And here, remember one thing, default is mandatory. So why the default is mandatory is, switch expressions are intended to return some value. So if you are expecting some return value and none of the case is executed, then no value will be returned. Let's say I'm passing, instead of Monday to Sunday, I'm passing XYZ. At that time, no case will be executed and no value will be returned. But switch must return some value in expressions. To return some value, default value, we have to keep like this. and this is expression, so with ended with semicolon. This is, let me remove this. Yeah, this is how we write a switch expression in Java 12 onwards. Java 12, it is a preview feature, and Java 14 onwards, it is a part of Java language. Yeah, let me run this one and how simple it is. See, let me pass some value like let's say Monday. I am passing here. What is the output? Yeah, and if I pass Tuesday, the output is B. We no need to bother about whether we kept break or not, all these things. Like break is not required here. See, nowhere we kept the break. And to return the value, simply we can do. You can ask one question like, how can I return, how can I write a multiple lines? So to write a multiple lines, we need to keep something like this in braces. And inside the break, you can write whatever. Let me print something. Testing multi-line cases, and here to return value here you need to use the yield keyword. And semicolon is required. Yeah. This is how we write yield. Multi lines we will write like this, and to return a value we will use yield keyword. Let me run this one and let me execute this. We have given multiple labels in one case. See how it is working. Let me run. Yeah, it is working properly. I passed Saturday and I got E, and if I pass Sunday, even in that case also, I have to get E. That is expected. Yeah. So this is how we write the expressions. Expressions are resolving the many of the issues, like it is able to return the value, and false through is got resolved. Like if you forget to keep the break, it is going to execute other, so that issue also resolved. And multiple labels we can keep, that is also one good thing here. And one more thing, even if you are intended to write switch expressions, if you want to write classic way also, you can write those. Backward compatibility also possible. So there are two ways you can write in Java 12 onwards. One is like a switch statements or switch expressions. Whatever you wish, you can write. Let me go to the next release, like Java 13. This is a second preview feature. Like Java 12, it introduced first preview. In Java 13, it is a second preview. And Java 14 onwards, it is part of JDK. So from Java 14, it is fully part of Java. That is how the switch is transformed from switch statement to switch expression. Recap on what we have learned so far. Like Java 1 to Java 14, switch is imported from C language. So whatever the features available in C language, all the features were imported into Java. But there are many limited features in perspective of developer usability. Like at the time, it was allowing only characters and numbers, characters and ints only. It doesn't allow any strings. In Java 5, enums are introduced, so enums are allowed inside switch cases. At the time, even though we are not able to go with the strings, but readability is improved with immutable strings. We can say switches are, we can use enums at that time. And Java 7 strings were introduced into switch. So from Java 7 onwards, we are able to use strings. And Java 12, it is transformed to switch expression. So either you can use as a switch statement or a switch expression. Using switch expression, we have seen example how we can write the code. It can able to return the value directly without using any return statement or anything. We no need to keep break, and we can write multi single line or single case with multiple labels. That's all about the transformation, all these things about switch. Thanks for watching, and please do subscribe my channel to get the latest updates. If you have any queries regarding this videos or any concepts related to Java or Python, you can provide your comments in the comment section. Signing off.